So I want to continue to talk about developing your unique branding position, and I want to talk about optimizing your evolution, the evolution of your brand. So one of the common mistakes that is made in branding in terms of when people decide to brand themselves per se, and even when they go to experts and experts help them to brand themselves, they will look at the journey that they've overcome or so what they've been through, and then they try to develop a brand around that particular concept. What I teach in branding metamorphosis is completely different. The journey is not the butterfly. So if you think about a caterpillar that has become something different, a different unique expression, it's a different entity, right? It's not who it was. So it's not actually designed to come and bring the journey to other people who were not already a part of that process in the metamorphosis. You have to look at what has the butterfly become. What is the evolution of the journey that needs to be optimized? I tell everyone that the cocoon process produces the content. So whatever you went through or so, that's what you actually create, publications or some products or maybe some type of sub-platform, and allow that to be how people level themselves up. But that is not what you should be branding yourself by, the overcomer's journey, or even the journey itself. The journey is not the butterfly. Butterflies actually don't go and teach other caterpillars how to come through the cocoon process. They go on to be butterflies and live the butterfly life in line with those tribes and discover what that new life is about. Branding is the same way when you go through a metamorphosis. But how you serve other people from your journey, again, is through publications and through, audio products or a specific platform that can then help to serve others in that way. But you go on to learn what this next level is for you in your branding evolution. Then you can accurately position yourself in the marketplace and then optimize your evolution. What have you actually become, right? But even what you have become begins a new journey that you have to learn what that new journey, what that new life of soaring is about. And you launch and land yourself from that unique position, all right? So something that I teach in my communications metamorphosis as well is that I teach people to write for caterpillars, speak to butterflies, meaning you can, again, produce the content and give people a process in a publication and maybe a complimentary audio or so or audios that can help them with that process and allow them to go through that journey themselves, or you yourself train up someone who has not come through their evolution yet and allow them to be the ones that take people through that process, maybe with your materials. But you yourself need to be in the more evolved state and to optimize it. I'm going to be honest with you. This is why most brands don't succeed long term. They have this fly-by-night success sometimes, a one-hit wonder type of thing, but can never produce consistency. Why is that? Because they've chosen to get fixated on a particular form and keep regurgitating the journey that has been versus continuing on in the evolution to know what the newness is about them, what they actually have become, right? So this is very important, not something, you know, taught. Well, I teach it, but I'm just saying it's not the traditional thing that is being taught in terms of the branding. So again, that's why most brands are suffering majorly, and they're struggling, inching along like caterpillars, so to speak, and most of the branding experts out there, of different ones in business, have convinced people that they're butterflies when they themselves are actually not butterflies. They're just bigger caterpillars with wings and hopes of dreams to fly with the illusion that they actually are. But they're actually not metamorphosized themselves. Therefore, they can't teach anyone else how to metamorphosize. They can teach you how to transform, But it's more like the tadpole to the frog. It just became a bigger version of what it was. A tadpole is a baby frog. The frog is a grown tadpole. So that's transformation, but it's not necessarily metamorphosis that has become something else, something different. The caterpillar goes in the cocoon, the chrysalis experience, and it breaks down. And it comes unformed to reform and be reformatted into a completely different entity of expression. So, therefore, it's not here to play out the journey that was or even bring that to the next phase of its life. And that's why I say to people, when you are going through a metamorphosis, that is when you need to be producing the content or taking someone else through that journey with you, even in your entrepreneurial state or branding or whatever. But when you come to your evolutionary vantage point, that should not be what you're continuing with. All right? So I have trainings and do teachings, around this aspect, and there'll be some information below that you can learn more about that. But it's time to optimize your evolution, and the evolution is discovering what has actually become of you as a brand. I can guarantee you it will not be from the journey that you have come out of, all right? But I definitely can show you how to reposition that, build a platform where that can serve that level of tribe or so that needs that from you, so you can get into your evolution of what you've become. So you can be metamorphosized, evolutionized, and optimized. That's, my training for the branding metamorphosis. So I look forward to being instrumental for you on your journey.